Like most villages in India, Baliganapalli has moved at its own pace. For 11-year-old Putti, time has stood still. She has always dreamed of getting an education, but she knows her fate has already been sealed. Putti does not want the same thing to happen to her 4-year-old brother, Putta. She asks her mother, Kamli, to send Putta to school.
ಕಳ್ತಿದ್ಯಮ್ಮ ಏನಾಯ್ತಮ್ಮ ಯಾಕೆ ಕಳ್ತಿದ್ಯಮ್ಮ ಹೇಳಮ್ಮ ಮಾತಾಡಮ್ಮ ನನ್ ಕಳ್ಳು ಕಿತ್ತು ಬತ್ತಾಯ್ತಲ್ಲೇ ಮಗ ನಿನ್ನಂತೂ ಓದ್ಸಕ್ಕಾಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಪುಟ್ಟನ್ನು ಓದ್ಸಕ್ಕೂ ನನ್ ಕೈಲಾಗ್ತಿಲ್ವಲ್ಲೇ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆ ಬರೋ ಯಾಕೆ ಹಿಂಗಾಗೋಯ್ತು ಅದ್ಯಾವ್ರಿಗೆ ಯಾಕೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮೇಲೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಕರುಣೆ ಬರ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಬರ್ತಾನೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ನಮ್ಗೆ ಕಟ್ಟಿಟ್ಟು ಬುತ್ತಿ ಆಗೋಯ್ತಲ್ಲೇ ನಾನೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿ ಒಂಟಿ ಹೆಂಗ್ಸು ನಾನೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿ ಪುಟ್ಟನ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲಿಗೆ ಕಳ್ಸು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ತಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮ ಹೇಳಮ್ಮ ನಾನಂತೂ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ನಿಂಗೆ ಅನುಕೂಲ ಆಗ್ಲಿ ಅಂತ ನಿನ್ ಜೊತೆ ದುಡಿತಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಹೇಳಮ್ಮ ನಾ ಹೇಳಿ ತಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮ ಹೇಳಮ್ಮ
ಕಮಲೀಸ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಟು ಹರ್ ಡಾಟರ್ಸ್ ಸಜೆಸ್ಟನ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ರಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಪೇರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೇರ್ಲಿ ಎನಫ್ ಫುಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹರ್ ಟು ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ವೆನ್ ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನಾಟ್ ಅಫೋರ್ಡ್ ಫುಡ್ ಹೌ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ದ ಗರ್ಲ್ ಈವನ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಎಡ್ಯುಕೇಷನ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ವಿಡೋ ಕಮಲೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಟಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಥೆಟಿಕ್
ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಉಣ್ಣಕ್ಕೂ ಇಡಕ್ಕಾಗ್ತಿಲ್ವಲ್ಲೇ ನನ್ನ ಕೈಲಿ ನಾನೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿ
ಅಮ್ಮ ನೀ ಅಳ್ಬೇಡಮ್ಮ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸರಿ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ ನೀ ಅಳ್ಬೇಡಮ್ಮ
ಪುಟ್ಟಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಹರ್ ಮದರ್ಸ್ ಸಫರಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಶಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಸ್ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಹರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ She tries to find out everything about the school from the other village children.
Hey, yen martta idiya alli? Yavaga nodu aa school hudugrindene. Manele esh kelsa vidaithe. Adannu madakilla neenu? Nadiya olage. Maartini. Yed
bidre yella. Kamli is unable to tolerate her daughter's thoughtless behavior. She reminds Putti that her work in the fields is more important than grand dreams of an education. It is the mother's and daughter's meager earnings that are keeping the family from starvation.
Angalve putti ninge yake nan maata artha agakilla vidya giddhi ella shrimantra sottu kane naavu tudiyo jana tudutrene nam jeevana nodu nanu nenu dudita irodrindlene ನಾವು ಮೂರು ಜನ ಒಂದೊತ್ತು ಗಂಜಿನಾದ್ರೂ ಕಾಣ್ತಿರೋದು ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಬೇಡ ಕಣೆ ನಿಂಗೆ ಯಾಕೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ನೀನ್ ಯಾಕೆ ನನ್ ಮಾತ್ ಕೇಳಲ್ಲ? ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳೆ ನನ್ ಮಾತು, ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳೆ.
ಅದೇನಿದು ಹೆಂಗನ್ಸದು? ಒಂದು ಎರಡು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇದು.
Putti will not give up her dream. She looks for every opportunity to learn what the other children are being taught.
ಹೆಂಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತದ?
Not for the first time, her mother has to drag Putti away from books to work in the fields.
ಯಾ ಸರಿ ಕೂಗಂದಿನ್ನ, ಒತ್ತಾದ ದಣಿಗಳು ಬೇರೆ ಬೈತಾರೆ. ನಡಿ ಬಾರೋ ನೀನು.
The chance arrival of Kamli's landlord gives her the idea of asking for a few extra rupees for her daughter's labor. The prosperous landlord rebukes her for continually asking for a raise. Kamli says that she did not face such difficulty when her husband was alive.
Nam puttige varakke 10 rupay kodta idri, mundin varadinda 15 rupay kotre ತುಂಬಾ ಉಪಕಾರ ಆಯ್ತದೆ ಬುದ್ಧಿ.
ಯಾಕೆ 20 ಕೊಟ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನು ಸುಖವಾಗಿರಲ್ವೇನು? ನೀನು ನಿನ್ ಮಗಳು ಮಾಡ್ತಿರೋ ಕೆಲ್ಸಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಕೆಲ್ಸಕ್ಕೆ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿರೋದೇ ಹೆಚ್ಚು. ದಿನ ದಿನ ಇದೇ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಆಗೋಯ್ತು ನಿಂದು.
ನಾನು ಹುಟ್ಟಿದಾಗಿಂದ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಕೆಲ್ಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ನಿಮ್ಮನ್ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇನ್ಯಾರನ್ನ ಕೇಳಿದಣಿ? ನನ್ ಗಂಡ ಬದುಕಿದ್ದಾಗ ಹಿಂಗಾಗಿರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಈಗಷ್ಟೇ ಇಂಥ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಬಂದೈತೆ.
ನಿನ್ನ ಗಂಡ ಅಂತೂ ಸಾಲ ಮಾಡಿ ಕುಡಿದು ಕುಡಿದು ಸತ್ತ, ಇನ್ನೇನು ನಿನ್ನ ಮಗ ನಿನ್ನ ಮಗಳು ಅದೇನು ದುಡ್ದು ಕಡ್ದು ಕಟ್ಟೆ ಹಾಕ್ತಿರೋ ನಾನು ನೋಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಯಾವಾಗ ಎದುರಿಗೆ ಬಂದರೂ ದುಡ್ಡು ದುಡ್ಡು.
ದ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಹರ್ ಬೈ ರೆಫರಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹರ್ ಹಸ್ಬೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಡ್ರಂಕನ್ನೆಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಕ್ರೂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾನರ್. ಹಿ ಟೆಲ್ಸ್ ಕಮ್ಲಿ ದಟ್ ಶೀ ಅಂಡ್ ಹರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಆರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. Putti tells her mother that they do not have to spend their lives being insulted by people like him. If her brother is educated, he may become a big government officer and they will not have to suffer this way.
ಸೇರ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಮ್ಮಿಬ್ರು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಸಾಕ್ತಾನಮ್ಮ, ಆವಾಗ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ ಹಂಗೂ ಇರಲ್ಲಮ್ಮ.
That night, Kamli overhears Putti asking her brother if he would like to go to school. She tries to talk her mother into sending him to school rather than to the fields. Her mother replies that it is already late and there is work to be done in the fields the next day.
Hey Putti, adene ado na malagok bidden in Ramayana beg malgi beg edu kelsa madodun bitta ರಾತ್ರಿ ಇಡೀ ಅವನ ಮಲಗೋಗ್ ಬಿಡದೆ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು. ಮಲಗೋ ಸುಮ್ನೆ.
ಅಮ್ಮ, ಪುಟ್ಟಂಗ್ ಓದಕ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಇಷ್ಟ ಅಮ್ಮ. ಅವನನ್ ಕೇಳ್ದೆ, ಹೂ ಅಂದ. ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಾವಿಬ್ರು ದನಿಗಳ ಹೊಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಓದ್ ದುಡಿಯೋಣಮ್ಮ. ಆದ್ರೆ ಪುಟ್ಟನ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಓದಿಸ್ಲೇಬೇಕಮ್ಮ.
ಸುಮ್ನೆ ಆಗದೆ ಇರೋದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಡ, ಮಲಗೋ. ಓದು ಇದು ಎಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಗಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳದ್ನಲ್ಲ,
ದೇವ್ರೇನಾದ್ರೂ ಕಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಪುಟ್ಟಂಗ್ ಓದಕ್ ಅವಕಾಶ ಸಿಕ್ಕ್ರೆ ನಿಂಗೆ ಒಪ್ಪಿಗೆ ಅಲ್ವಮ್ಮ? ಹೂ ಅನ್ನಮ್ಮ.
ಮಲಕು, ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ಬೇಗ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕು.
ಹ್ಮ್.
Is there no hope for their dreams and aspirations? What is the way out? For Putta and millions of rural children like him in India, there is no light at the end of the tunnel. One day, a jeep arrives in the village. The person who alights from the jeep is greeted by the panchayat vice chairman and curious onlookers. The vice chairman introduces the newcomer to a village school teacher. They proceed towards a small hut. Visitor talks, Putti realizes that there is a ray of hope. The visitor speaks of Shanti Bhavan, a school that will provide free education for the little boy.
From your life, we do not want him to suffer as you are suffering. We would like him to grow up and help you, help your family. And we do not want anything from you except you must visit your child, you must encourage him, you can take him home for the holidays, you can come and see our school and understand what we are doing.
Kamali does not know what to think. She decides to ask the village elders for advice. Kamali discusses the offer made by the school principal. Some of the village elders caution her that her child could be used for conversion to Christianity or for beggary. The panchayat vice chairman advises Kamali to make use of the opportunity and to take it from there. Shanti Bhavan is a school and a home for economically disadvantaged children. It provides world-class education, care, and facilities. It is founded on the belief that poor children are no different from rich children. If they are given the opportunity, they have as much chance to succeed as any other children. This is a turning point in 4-year-old Putta's life. Kamali has made the decision to send her child to Shanti Bhavan. The family's departure is viewed with skepticism by the village community. Let us take a moment to meet Dr. Abraham George, who has made it possible to turn this dream into a reality.
From very young age, I wanted to do something with poor children, but I didn't have a clear idea as to what I wanted to do. And I certainly wasn't able to do anything because I didn't have the money to do it. I realized that what I would be good at would be starting an institution that is based on some principles that I have learned as a businessman. Shanti Bhavan is a non-sectarian institution. We do not promote any religion, any particular religion, but we respect and value all religions. We teach our children. Shanti Bhavan is founded on four basic principles. The first one is the pursuit of excellence. The second guiding principle is the practice of globally shared values. These are honesty, integrity, and transparency. The third principle that we try to practice is developing humane values such as kindness, generosity, sensitivity about others' feelings, being good to others, the kind of things that are not necessarily business-oriented but very interpersonal. And we hope that our children will grow up to be not just simply very successful in what they do, but they know how to deal with each other, and they're very successful in their personal relationships. We select children from poor backgrounds, socially and economically deprived backgrounds. We make sure that we give them the very best we can so that they grow up to be extremely successful in their adult lives. We hope that they will be leaders of the society, that they will be professionals, and or whatever their God-given capacities will allow them to succeed the very best they can be.
Children are selected by a four-member selection team, which includes the school principal.
These children, they come from socially deprived. When I mean socially deprived, they are children who live in poverty condition, families with single parenthood, children with where no both the parents are not there, and we have taken a few children from some of the institutions who cater with destitute children.
A pediatrician conducts a medical checkup to rule out serious physical or mental handicaps. A clinical psychologist with a background in child psychology examines the child for her ability to complete a school program successfully.
For selection, we have used various psychological tests to measure their intelligence, social skills, and writing and motor skills.
Good morning, Abhi.
The policy and procedures manual of Shanti Bhavan prescribes a predictable daily routine for the children. They have their own independent lockers so that they imbibe a sense of personal belongings. The child's physical, mental, social, and spiritual well-being is of primary importance.
God, thank you for this day.
Tasty, nutritious meals are provided. The facilities at Shanti Bhavan have been designed to give the children the very best. The focus of the staff's efforts is to give the children a sense of their uniqueness. The future of these children does not hinge on academics alone. The principal shares some thoughts.
Bigs. This is the cover. Now I move to the title page. And here, please sit down. On this title page, you can see 1, 2, 3 little pigs.
Shanti Bhavan is not just a school for children, it is also a home. It is a place where we want them to imbibe what is the best of their culture. We don't want them to develop into socially dislocated persons who are embarrassed of their own origins, of their families, who will not acknowledge their parents or their heritage when they grow up. This is a tremendous challenge for all of us. And because of this, the staff at Shanti Bhavan have very high standards of accountability and commitment to the vision and the goals of the George Foundation. We want these children to be worthy citizens, not only of Tamil Nadu and Karnataka or India, but of the world.
The foundation started its activities about 3 years back. Dr. Abraham George is the managing trustee and the founder of the George Foundation. He is devoted a lot of his wealth to this project, and he is recently devoting a lot of his time into this venture apart from his usual business commitments. It took us almost 14 to 15 months to bring it to the present condition.
On the first of Kamli's bi-monthly visits to her son, she is overwhelmed. Putti is proud of her little brother.
Children here are provided with nutritious food prepared in most advanced mechanized kitchen. We also have our own vegetable garden.
The children's nutrition is looked after by the pediatrician. She prescribes menus suitable for their growth and development. Shanti Bhavan has its own horticultural garden. Garden fresh vegetables are available for daily consumption. Thousands of fruit tree saplings have been planted. The abundance of sunlight makes solar energy a viable proposition for heating, lighting and pumping purposes at Shanti Bhavan. Utta returns home for a 15-day visit. After 2 days, he wants to return to Shanti Bhavan. He tells his mother that he misses his friends and that he wants to be an astronaut. Kamli is touched, but she also realizes that she cannot provide what Shanti Bhavan gives to her child. She has to sacrifice her own feelings in the interest of Putta's future.
ಆಯ್ತು ಪುಟ್ಟ, ಬಾ. ನಿನಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋ ವಿದ್ಯೆ ನಾನಂತೂ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ. ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಿನಗೆ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಭವಿಷ್ಯ ಇರೋ ಹಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ನೀನು ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಪ್ಪ. ನಾನು ನಿನ್ನ ಶಾಂತಿ ಭವನಕ್ಕೆ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತೀನಿ, ಆಯ್ತಾ?
ಮಾನಂ ತೆಳಿಯೇ ನಿನ್ನಾ ಮನಸ್ಸು ನೀರನ್ನೇ ವನ್ನಾ ವೇಣಂ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣಂ ನಾಣಂ ಕುಂಜು ಜಾಲಾಟ್ಟುಂ ನಿರಮಾರಿ ಚೆಲ್ಲಂ ಚೆಲ್ಲಂ ತಾಳಂ ತೂಮೇಳಂ മണിച്ചേലോലും മോലേഞ്ഞാലി ഇനി കാത്തുമ്പി പെണ്ണാൾക്ക് പാലിയും കൊണ്ടേ
മാനം
തേടി
mother's duty does not end with the setting of the sun. She has to be alert at night in case a child needs attention. The pediatrician advises the staff on the care of the children.
My expectation is that they will achieve their full potential, whatever that may be, and that they'll grow up to be well-rounded, happy individuals, and that they will be good human beings.
Deepavali, Christmas and Eid are celebrated to teach children to respect each other's differences. Birthdays are also celebrated. Children blossom with the care they receive in the open, unpolluted environment of Shanti Bhavan. Putta and hundreds of children like him can aspire to a great future because of the vision of one individual. Shanti Bhavan has a global outlook with an indigenous background. Rabindranath Tagore wrote, "Thy infinite gifts come to me only on these very small hands of mine. Ages pass, and still thou pourest, and still there is room to fill." Puranagar